Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining this video cast on polyurethanes for wetting and dispersing agents. These are high molecular weight polymers with multiple pigment affinity groups for improved wettability and enhanced color development. With me today is Brent Laurenti from our automotive end use. Thank you so much for sharing your expertise in the area of polyurethanes with us today. Before we begin, please tell us a little bit more about your end use.
Sure. So I'm responsible for the automotive and aerospace end use. And as you know, the color becomes a really big important factor for automotive. It plays into the purchasing decisions people make for cars, and it really leads into the emotion that they try to elicit when trying to help you decide which car to buy. And so color becomes really key for the automotive designers as well, and trying to figure out, well, what color do I want to put on this new model of car? The designers are always asking for, more transparent colors or more vibrant colors, et cetera. And wetting dispersing additives, especially the polyurethanes, play a pretty big role in helping them achieve their goals.
I certainly cover the benefits of stabilizing pigments in nearly every presentation. What benefits are there for stabilizing color dispersions in your automotive end use?
Oh, this is really, really important in automotive. And we can really separate it into OEM and refinish. They each have, they're equally important, but they have different focuses a little bit. So on the OEM side, so thinking about the car coming off the assembly line, right? Color consistency is really important because what a lot of people don't necessarily realize is the car isn't all painted at once, right? So you'll have different add-on parts like your mirror housings or your bumpers or spoiler or something that may be painted in another location. And so when the car is finally assembled, all those parts need to be equal color. If you go and buy a car, you want everything to look like it was all painted at once and not painted separately. So that plays a big role. And also on the OEM side, right, it's very important that the car that rolls off the assembly line today, if it's painted a bright blue, that bright blue matches the bright blue that came off the assembly line 3 weeks ago. So that's really important for the manufacturers, that color consistency remains over all these parts in different time periods. Right. If you're thinking about like refinish, this is, again, similar, but in refinish, you have a couple other things that come in play. Refinish, you have a situation where a color concentrate or a pigment dispersion may sit on the shelf for years at a time. So it's very important for that dispersion to be stable over a pretty lengthy period of time, so that when they go to use it, they get a consistent color. And then, also you have to keep in mind these body shops, they have to be able to match color, thousands and thousands of colors, because your local body shop, they have to match a color of a 10-year-old Volvo or the latest BMW. It doesn't really matter. They have to match all those colors. So it's really critical for them to have, consistent colors, so they know what to work with, so that the color matchers in the shop can do their job the way the consumers expect them to.
I know myself, thinking about it as just obviously a car owner, not really understanding the intricacies of all the different parts and what happens if I'm in a car accident or something. What I really want to know is, how can polyurethanes really help wet and disperse those properly?
Oh, excellent question. And really, you've probably touched on the main answer, the main reason. And really, it's the high molecular weight and the large amount of pigment affinity groups that play are one of the most obvious reasons that the polyurethanes are successful at this. Most of the pigments that are being used in this automotive and aerospace fields are high surface area organic pigments. And if you think about like carbon black, for example, that's going to be probably the highest surface area pigment that most people are going to work with, right? And so this enormous surface area needs to be completely coated by the wetting dispersing additive. And the polyurethanes, because their chemistry, again, that high molecular weight, these large number of affinity groups, they do a really good job of trying to help cover all that surface area so you can stabilize the pigment and then get the maximum benefit out of the pigment. And in case of carbon black, it's usually jetness. Everyone wants a jet black car.
Absolutely. Really, the key point here is stabilization. Can you emphasize that for us?
Absolutely. But I think the two things I would just focus on is one, making sure we do a ladder study to determine the right amount of additive is being used. But then once you do that, I think probably the best test, the easiest first stage test that people should be doing is a rub out. And again, this is something that I didn't really think about so much until getting to work with you a little bit and a little more in depth. Because I think in the automotive sector, they're going to analyze things to a great degree, and they're going to do a lot of advanced testing down the line. But when it comes down to it, if you do a rub out initially to check for flocculation, this is just a fantastic, very easy tool to check and make sure that, okay, we're on the right path and we've got fairly good stabilization. And then if I'm good with a rub out, then I can take it to the more advanced testing and make sure my delta E is where it needs to be and everything else. So.
They are so quick and easy. They're too simple not to do, honestly. So we touched on your end use. We touched on consistency of color and the benefits of stabilization. I want to ask you, what are your favorite Bic additives?
Sure. So on the polyurethane dispersions, really the workhorses in for a number of years have been a product, DisperBic 163. I mean, there's a few in this DisperBic 160 family, but 163 is probably the workhorse. We now have a DisperBic 167, which is a HAPS-free version of the 163, and that's probably going to be a little more popular going forward as environmental regulations come into play. And then even more recently, again, just kind of different flavors here, we've come up with a 10-free version of both the DisperBic 163 and 167. Traces of organotin. Organotin is used as a catalyst in the production. So there are traces in there, and that's becoming an issue for certain applications. So if presence of 10 is an issue, Bic does have a solution. So that's maybe a longer answer than you wanted, but that encompasses the most widely used and favorite ones in my world.
No, it's a perfect answer. Thank you. And I do want to ask you, are there any other things, anything else that you want to leave our audience?
I would say anytime you're trying to find the best wetting dispersing additive, I can't stress enough to, give your local Bic rep a call. We're here to make your life easier. And so don't hesitate to reach out.
Couldn't agree more. If you need any help, have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to our help desk. And I want to thank you all for your time. And thanks to you, Brent.
Thank you, Michelle. Thanks for having me.